My favorite cousin Seiyu was born in a beloved family with a Down syndrome, which is a genetic disorder that causes mental retardation. She was such a funny, easygoing, and bright girl, but as she got older, her disease has gotten worse. When she attended elementary school, there were a couple of other disabled students entering general education classes, but other students' contact and acceptance remained elusive. In the lunchroom, the kids with disabilities sat separately. No one approached them, came up and said hi, or joined them. I guess the elementary school kids were too young to understand the differences, but it was still an uncomfortable experience for my cousin. However, not only in schools, but many people tend to avoid those who make us feel uncomfortable or guilty. So, if we just look at the quick facts, nearly 2.9 million students are currently receiving special education services for learning disabilities in the U.S. In those numbers, two-thirds of the secondary students with disabilities were reading three or more grade levels behind. More than 27% of these children drop out of high school compared to 11% of the general student population. Now, these are not just small numbers that we're looking at, but there are actually a lot of them. They have rights to live and study just like normal students, but they might need some special care to fit into the classroom. Bringing students with disabilities into general education classrooms should result in true long-term acceptance. The approaches could vary by place to place, but I think only classrooms would naturally follow when the classroom attitudes are inclusive. Basically, inclusive education means that students with disabilities are supported in chronologically age-appropriate general education classes in schools and receive the specialized instruction within the context of the core curriculum and general class activities. Inclusion is there to make sure that students with disabilities don't feel left out and they could go to school along with their friends while also receiving whatever instruction and support they need to achieve high standards and succeed as learners. A research also showed that in a 3-year study of inclusive education in an elementary school, all students experienced improvements in social skills and increases in self-esteem related to their abilities and accomplishments. This not only benefits the disabled students, but students without disabilities experience growth in social cognition and gain a greater understanding and acceptance of students with disabilities and of diversity in general when they experience inclusive education. Now, in order to achieve all of this, appropriate resources, support for both students and teachers, good teacher training and planning time, and a commitment to a vision of success for all students is vital to the success of inclusive education. Also, the use of technology, including audiotape books, closed captioning, and computers, are seen as a diversity accommodation tool and to improve the learning opportunities for all students. I believe that even though this method might not work out in all situations, if we only have strong commitment and each of us just shows a little bit of effort to help these students, a big change will come sooner than we think.